ready to match the star. Ron Mason, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Patty Duke Aston, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Beautifont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Ryder.
Yeah. You got me, Gene. Hey, Gene.
What?
There's some guys over there robbing the bank.
They don't believe in God.
You got me. I think the ding-a-lings are ready, don't you? All ding-a-lings ready.
Hello.
Ding-a-ling.
Let's say hello to Robin Denson and Donna Kersey. Hello there, ladies. Here's our champ with $11,550. You're a very chic lady. Oh,
thank you.
You buy your own clothes?
No, I make all my clothes.
You make all your own clothes?
Oh, she does.
You made this?
Yes.
That's very attractive. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Now, we welcome Donna Kersey. We're delighted to meet you, and we ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, I'm married. My husband is a swimming pool builder. And we live out in Yorba Linda. We have a fantastic little 14-month-old girl named Shelley.
Well, we hope you win some money here.
I like that.
So you can build a swimming pool for yourself.
Oh, we already have one.
Oh, you have one?
Of course.
Darn it. Well, then you can build one for your kid. And side by side. Never mind. Well, it's 1 minute and 2 seconds away from beginning this game between Donna and Robin. Are you ready? Are you ready, ladies? Here we go. Now, Donna.
A, please.
A. All right, new game from the top.
Okay.
Dr. Frankenstein said,
my monster just got married. He thinks his bride is a beautiful girl, but she really looks just like blank.
He said that he just got married.
Monster just got married. He thinks his bride is a beautiful girl, but she really looks just like blank.
I know exactly who she looks like, but I'd never write it down.
Did you hear all of that? My monster just got married. He thinks his bride is a beautiful girl, but she really looks just like... Okay, just like...
Did you think of an answer? You know about Frankenstein and the monster and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And he said the monster just got married. He thinks his bride is a beautiful girl, but she really looks just like...
Brett.
I love this audience. I love them.
They goaded her into saying that. She really didn't want to say
it. And you know what I'm going to do?
Yeah.
I'm going to take those silly little writers and I'm going to chain them to the driving lot and then I'm going to run over them.
Okay. I'll drive the car.
I've had it with those jokes. I'm saying that on the air, fellas.
Okay. Now, Ron.
You know, as a constant viewer, I'm always amazed at how they pick on Brett constantly. I said Brett.
You said Brett.
The only person I could think of was... But I didn't say it. I said Bela Lugosi.
Bela Lugosi. Splendid.
The only person that I could think of was... I said Brett.
So that's two, Donna. He thinks his bride is a beautiful girl, but she really looks just like blank.
No, I really don't feel this way. And I only said it because I watched the show and I heard all the jokes about you.
She just added another one.
I don't like those jokes either.
Well, we do kid Brett
a lot. I like the ones about dressing Oscar.
Now, Richard.
I'm not joking. I really feel this way.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not joking either. I really feel this way.
She's a Richard Dawson.
Yes,
so that's fair for you.
What's going on there? Behind my back.
Okay. Now, Robin, this is yours. I have a little poem for you now. A poem.
Okay.
Said Dr. Creel to Mr. Neal, "Your stomach, I feel, will never heal. The lining has begun to peel."
Oh, gee.
"What did you have for your last meal?" "A simple snack," said Mr. Neal. "A giant chocolate-covered blank."
Now, who could follow that?
Well, all you do, remember the rhyming word.
Would you repeat the question, please?
Said Dr. Creel to Mr. Neal, "Your stomach, I feel, will never heal. The lining has begun to peel. What did you have for your last meal?" "A simple snack," said Mr. Neal. "A giant chocolate-covered blank."
All right, if you insist.
Easy. I got it.
See how easy it is? All right. That doesn't rhyme.
No, that was my second choice.
Oh, that was the second choice.
I can write to myself if I want
to. Oh, you're writing to yourself.
Well, then I'm going
to
mail them.
Yeah. We're waiting for you, Gary.
I know. I'm so stunned, really.
Meal, tremendous feel, heal, peel. Those are the words. Oh, you finished. All right.
That's what I call balling a jack.
Said Dr. Creel to Mr. Neal, "Your stomach, I feel, will never heal. The lining has begun to peel. What did you have for your last meal?" "A simple snack," said Mr. Neal. "A giant chocolate-covered..."
"Seal."
"Seal. Okay. That's one. Big chocolate-covered seal. That'll give you indigestion. Go ahead, Ron."
"I went with a delicacy."
"What?"
"Seal was very expensive. I went with eel."
"Eel. Okay. Correct. A giant chocolate-covered..."
"Orville, I thought you just made fur coats out of seals. I said eel."
"Eel. Eel is good. Seal is good. I think I would have said eel. What did you say, Gare?"
"I say, may I be excused for just a few minutes?"
"Well, you got a rotten answer again?"
I'd rather not answer that question, to tell you the truth. I forgot what I said. I said, oh, yes, I said banana peel.
Banana peel.
I think I just slipped over my entire career.
I said eel, too.
So there's another eel. Got a lot of eels and one banana peel. And...
L. It's a very poor eel.
Yes.
Oh, dear.
Now, she's looking for a chocolate-covered seal. What do you say? She had L also and just added the E at this moment.
I never did.
That's where my other E went.
That's where your other E went.
Which you'd never copy.
Yeah. Okay, so it's 4-0 at this moment, at the end of round one. And now before we go to round two, we want to talk with you. The score at this moment is 4-0 in favor of our challenger. And we go to round two and ask the challenger to make a selection.
A again.
A again. Only two people play this time. Brett and...
Dumbo.
And Joyce. Brett and Joyce, right. Now, you ladies remember Rapunzel? Remember the hair of the girl in the tower with the really long hair? Right.
I remember.
How long was it?
Well, I'll tell you. Rapunzel said,
blank.
"Every Saturday night, Sir Prancelot asks me to let down my hair. What a drag. That weirdo doesn't climb it. All he does is blank it." That's what she said about Sir Prancelot.
I'm certainly glad I'm not answering this question.
You lay out there. Okay, Brett's finished. All right. Now, Robin. I mean, Donna. You know about Rapunzel.
No, I don't.
May I tell the story?
Well, no, you may not tell the story because it's my show. Rapunzel is a fairy story about a girl who sat in a castle. She had very long hair. And when her... Well, a guy who turned out to be her lover later on, but they don't tell that to the kids, you see. I knew later on, I know what happened between the two of them, but they never said that to me when I was a kid, found out many years later. He would climb up to her balcony by grabbing a hold of her hair. And that,
Are you sure you don't want me to tell it?
No. Anyway, there's a girl with named Rapunzel with long hair. And every Saturday night, Sir Prancelot asked me to let down my hair, and what a drag. That weirdo doesn't climb it, as he did in the fairy story. See, all he does is blanket.
Comb it. That's all I can think of.
All I can think of is comb it. Well, that's not bad. What do you say?
What do you mean that's not bad?
Well,
I think that's a perfectly wonderful answer.
Why would you say a thing like that?
Because that's what I said.
Naturally. Now you're up next.
I always say the weirdest things.
Well, this guy was a weirdo, Sir Prancelot.
This time I didn't, I said Combs.
Oh! Now, pressure on you, Robin.
Yeah.
You know what you have to do. Got to match all six to stay in the game. So everybody listen carefully. Thelma said to the fortune teller, some fortune teller you are, you told me I'd meet a tall, dark man who'd make me rich. Well, all I met was a short, fat man who made me blank. Thelma said to the fortune teller, some fortune teller you are, you told me I'd meet a tall, dark man who'd make me rich. All I met was a short, fat man who made me blank.
And would you read the question again and give me the answer?
All I met was a short, fat man who made me blank. All right.
Wait a minute.
Okay, Ron, and everybody ready in the lower tier? All right. Now, Robin, Thelma said to the fortune teller, some fortune teller you are, you told me I'd meet a tall, dark man who'd make me rich. Well, all I met was a short, fat man who made me...
sick.
Sick?
Yeah, sick.
Really?
Rich.
Rich.
Made me sick.
Too late now.
Yeah.
Too late now. That's your answer. You have second thoughts.
Okay. No, no.
Okay, Ron. Go.
I've heard you many times turn around to Brett and say, this is my show.
Yeah.
Therefore, I wanted it to remain your show, so I just kept my answer simple and said poor.
Poor it is. So that means Donna wins the game. What do you have, Brett?
That's what I was going to say.
Robin's going to leave us, but she's leaving a wealthy lady with $11,550. Good luck to you in your career. You better make it. Goodbye, Robin Benson. Hello there.
Hi.
Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
All right, let's get right to it. We polled a recent studio audience, Donna. We got their best response to this. Blank liberty. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, and then $250, then $100. Whom do you call on here?
Joyce.
Oh, you do? First, Statue of Liberty.
Okay. Statue of Liberty is one.
Richard.
Richard.
Miss Liberty.
Miss Liberty.
Big show.
And Gary.
Give me Liberty or give me Brett. Give me Liberty is all.
Give me Liberty. All right, you got Give Me Liberty, Miss Liberty, and Statue of Liberty. Do you want one of those or have you got a better one?
I'll take Statue of Liberty.
Statue of Liberty seems like a good response, the one Joyce gave you. Let's find out if it's up there. And if it's there, where is it? That is the question. Is it under the $100 response? Give Me Liberty is up there. That's the one that Gary gave you.
You could throw me a kiss.
What's that?
She could throw me a kiss for that.
Yeah, sure. All right, we are looking for the Statue of Liberty. Are you under the $250 response? Cinderella Liberty. Last chance for the Statue of Liberty. Here's the $500 response. Yes. Congratulations. Okay. Now, Donna, you got the $500. You to play for the $5,000. Whom do you call on?
I'll take Joyce.
Oh.
Okay, Joyce, you get ready to write. Or you'll face me. And here we go with the $5,000 question. Slice of blank. Okay, she's finished. Now we call on you, Donna, to give us your answer. One you think will match hers. What do you say to that? Slice of...
cake.
No?
No.
No? Well, we'll find out. Oh, wait a minute. Brett. Joyce, may we see your answer for $5,000? She says, slice of...
This is a coordinated monthly test of the broad...
Here we are again. You ready, Donna?
I'm ready.
Okay, we're very pleased to introduce another player. Let's welcome Susie Tassoni. Now, Susie, I see you have a lucky rabbit's foot there.
I have my rabbit's foot, a peso, and a St. Christopher.
You got it all, I'll say that.
Them that big-chested girls are stupid, that's because my brains fell.
Is that what your mother always said?
Right.
Well, I don't think you're stupid. I'll find any man in this bar who says you're stupid.
We're in a lot of trouble.
Yes,
the only
right.
thing I can think of is you see what happens when you eat your vegetables.
Yes. Where are you from, Susie?
I'm from Carson. I'm married. My husband, he's okay. And I have two wonderful daughters.
Nice to hear that. You're married to a good guy. You know, everybody comes up here and says, I am married to the most terrific guy in the world. She says, my husband's okay.
Right. No, he's terrific. I never said that.
No, I know that.
Your husband wasn't okay.
That's right. Now we got a round one here, Susie. Okay. Please make a selection.
I'll take A.
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 You sure?
Positive.
Okay. Now.
What does it matter? She's aces high in your book, honey.
Dumb Dora picked up the phone and said, hello. Hello, this is the Lost and Found. This is Dumb Dora. I want to report that I just lost my blank on the roller coaster. Dumb Dora said, hello, this is the Lost and Found. I want to report that I just lost my blank on the roller coaster.
I love that laugh. Who was that?
You know, Gene.
Yes.
The big chested, you know, are not dumb.
No.
Victor Mature was a very smart person.
Okay, the Lord Gear is ready. You ready, Ron? Here we go. Susie. Dumb Dora picked up the phone and said, hello, Lost and Found. This is Dumb Dora. I want to report that I just lost my blank on the roller coaster.
My wig?
My wig. It may be true what they say, but I don't know. No, I'm only kidding.
Your mother was wrong. Only kidding.
I'm still working on St. Christopher and Peso.
That's right.
I said Dumb Dora lost her lunch.
Her lunch. Okay.
That's not bad.
No, wait a minute. That's a pretty good yes.
Now, see, sweetheart. If you lose something, if you lose your wig, you can call the Lost and Found, and they'll give it back to you. So she had to lose something you could never get back. And it was her innocence.
Her innocence. On a roller coaster.
Oh,
so wonderful. A great experience. Yes, Gary.
Well, love is a roller coaster.
Yes.
Life is not a fountain.
Life
They're
is
all
a fountain.
Coming back today, Gene.
Yes.
All of those jokes. I said virginity.
Virginity.
I didn't know you could say that.
You can't.
Yes. I would have said that.
Is that what you were thinking?
That's why I said teeth.
Teeth. She was thinking virginity and said teeth there.
I lost my teeth in San Francisco.
That's right. Okay.
It's an old Dumb Dora.
Well, now for a real answer.
I have to go now.
Now stick around.
El Virtue.
El Virtue. Okay, Joyce.
She was really dumb. She let go of the best thing she ever had.
Dumb Dora?
Yeah.
What was that?
Her boyfriend.
Her boyfriend. Well, that's not bad. Hello, lost and found. I lost my boyfriend on the roller coaster. Okay, now, that's the first question in our round one, and we've got more to go, but before we do anything, we got to do a little business here, and this is it. The two of you ladies will certainly come back next time, won't you?
Yes.
Okay. And we'll look forward to seeing you. And we'll look forward to seeing you.
Oh,
you were all just peachy keen.
Thank you, Gene.
I mean, peachy keen. Is there something I can do for anyone before we go?
Oh, would you scratch my back? It's been killing me the whole show.
Can't do that.
You must go and see Patty and her husband in her play.
Oh, in Seattle. Right. The play's called...
At the Moore Theater in The Marriage Gamble.
The Marriage Gamble. All right, thank you for that.
Thank
you. Now, next time we get together, these are the bodies who will appear on this here now stage.
Avery Schreiber. Brett Summer. Gary Murgoff, Arlene Francis, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson Bill Tubman production. Stay tuned for Title Tales next over most of these CBS stations.